As part of computer networks, there is one important concept which is related to data link layer, that is exponential backup algorithm. So we know that this exponential backup algorithm we can use as part of MAC protocols, which is access control is the functionality of data link layer, where we are handling the collisions. So to handle the collisions, this data link layer is using a component called MAC protocol. So the data link layer is using MAC protocol to handle the collisions. This we know, right? So this MAC protocol, or else whatever the MAC protocols we are having, like Aloha, CSMA, CSMA-CD, CSMA-CA, TDMA, FDMA, SDMA, poll, select, reservation. So whatever the MAC protocols we are having, so mainly among those MAC protocols, if you consider random access protocols, if you consider random access protocols like Aloha, CSMA, CSMA-CD, CSMA-CA, so these MAC protocols are working based on this particular exponential backup algorithm. So in this session, we are going to know about this exponential backup algorithm. Okay, right. So coming to this exponential backup algorithm, let's check the statement of this algorithm. So what is the statement of exponential backup algorithm is, so when there is a collision takes place between the frames, or else when multiple frames are collided together, or else when there is a collision takes place between the frames, before making the retransmission of those collisioned frames, the sender has to wait some amount of time. That waiting time is given as backup waiting time is equals to k into 51.2 microseconds, where k is a random variable which can be chosen in the range of 0 to 2 to the power of n minus 1, where n is number of collisions. So this is what the statement of exponential backup algorithm. So this statement we are going to do some analysis. On this particular statement, we are going to do some analysis. So have a look at that analysis now. Okay? Right. So coming to analysis. So here, the analysis we are starting from this n. We are starting from this n. Okay? So before going to start this analysis, let me know how we are getting, or else how we are getting this 51.2 microseconds. So how we are getting this 51.2 microseconds is, there is some points which we need to recall here. So what are the points we need to recall here is, if you consider CSMA-CD, the CSMA-CD, it is a MAC protocol which we are using as part of Ethernet. As part of Ethernet, specifically as part of wired Ethernet, we are using the CSMA-CD as a MAC protocol to handle the collisions. So, how we are getting this 51.2 microseconds? To know that, we are using the parameters, we are using some parameters of this Ethernet. So, as part of the parameters of Ethernet, one of the parameter is minimum frame size. So what is the minimum frame size of Ethernet is 64 bytes. So the minimum frame size of Ethernet is 64 bytes or 512 bits. So this is what one parameter we need to consider. And the another parameter is, what is the bandwidth of this Ethernet? So the bandwidth of Ethernet is 10 Mbps. So we know that this Ethernet is classified into basically three types. One is standard Ethernet, another one is fast Ethernet, and another one is gigabit Ethernet. So standard Ethernet is providing 10 Mbps of data rate, fast Ethernet is providing 100 Mbps of data rate, and gigabit Ethernet is providing 1000 Mbps of data rate. So minimum frame size in all these Ethernets are same, which is 64 bytes or else 512 bits. And we are considering standard Ethernet here. Since its bandwidth is 10 Mbps, we have written this statement here. So the bandwidth is 10 Mbps. Okay. So now, so what is the meaning of this bandwidth here? So here it is saying that 10 megabits per second. Let's suppose this is my Ethernet channel. This is my Ethernet channel, standard Ethernet channel. On this, what is the bandwidth of this standard Ethernet channel? 10 Mbps, which means that 10 megabits can be transferred from sender to receiver. But according to this statement, minimum frame size. So what does it mean? If it is my standard Ethernet, which can carry 10 megabits per second from sender to receiver, among this much capacity of this standard Ethernet, I just placing minimum 512 bits. So it means that this 512 bits, can I consider as a bandwidth delay product of Ethernet or not? Yes, so I can consider this band, I can consider this 512 bits as a bandwidth delay product. So that's why we are writing a statement here. The statement is bandwidth delay product, which is B into RTT, is equals to 512 bits. Then RTT is equals to 512 by 10 into 10 power 6, which is 10 Mbps. So then if you simplify this expression, you will get 51.2 microseconds. So this is the way how we are getting this 51.2 microseconds. So this is the value which we are using with respect to the numerical. But with respect to the theoretical, what is the value we can use? That is K into RTT. What do you mean by RTT? 2 into TP. So back off waiting time, theoretically you can say K into 2 into TP. Back off waiting time, numerically you can say K into 51.2 microseconds. So 51.2 microseconds is the value of RTT, which is 2 into TP. Clear with me? So this is the way how we are getting 51.2 microseconds in this situation. Clear? Right. So now we are going to start the analysis part. So coming to this analysis, so the analysis we are starting from, as we mentioned, from N. So assuming that N value is 0. So if N value is 0, so what does it mean is collision number is 0. So collision number is 0 means what? There is no collision between the frames. So then what is the possible values of K? So if N is 0, then 2 power 0, which is 2 power 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 0, so 0 to 0. This is the value which we can have with respect to the K. That is what we have mentioned. K is a random variable which can be chosen in the range of 0 to 0. So it means that when N is equals to 0, K value can be 0. And assuming that if N value is 1, so if there is only one time of collision between the frames, then what are the possible values for K? So 0 to, so now N value is 1, 2 power 1, which is 2, 2 minus 1, 1. So 0 to 1. So it means that 0 comma 1 is the possible, are the possible values for K when there is a first time collision between the frames. So assuming that if there is a second time collision between the frames, then what are the possible values for K? So the possible values for K is 0 to 2 square by 2. What is this 2 square? 4. 4 minus 1? 3. So 0 to 3. It means that 0, 1, 2 and 3. These are the values for K when there is a second time collision. And if we consider N is equals to 3, then the K value is 0 to 2 to the power of 3 minus 1. 2 to the power of 3 is 8. 8 minus 1, 7. So 0 to 7. So means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Clear? So now what is these values are called? So what is this 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What are these values are said to be? So these values are said to be contention slots. These values are said to be contention slots. And this window, I mean this set is said to be contention window. This set is said to be contention window. Clear with me? So, contention window. So, this is called contention window, and these values are said to be contention slots. So, what do you mean by contention? We'll let you know slowly, okay? But these slots are said to be, these values are said to be contention slots, and that window, the set is said to be contention window. So, simply, what do you mean by contention window? So, contention window means it is a collection of contention slots. It is a collection of contention slots. Okay? Right. So, now, look at this. For n is equals to 0, what is the contention window size of k? So, what is the contention window size of k? Since it is having only one value, one contention slot, clear with me, the contention window size for k is 1 when n is equals to 0. When n is equals to 1, then what is the contention window size of k? That is 0 comma 1, means 2. So, the contention window size is 2 when the collision number is 1. When the collision number is 0, contention window size of k is 1. When collision number is 1, then the contention window size of k is 2. When collision number is 2, then the contention window size of k is 4. And when there is a collision number 3, then the contention window size of k is 0 to 7, which is 8. So, it means that this is called an exponential growth in the contention window or not. Yes. So, that is what we are going to write. So, it seems that, so if I go like this, then I can write a point, that is, it seems that there is an exponential growth. There is an exponential growth in contention window size. It seems that there is an exponential growth in the contention window size. So, that's why this algorithm, so basically this is simply back-off algorithm. Later we have added exponential back-off algorithm, because we are having exponential growth in the contention window, okay? So, that's why this algorithm is also referred as exponential back-off algorithm. Exponential back-off algorithm. Okay? So, initially it is just back-off algorithm. But after identifying this point, what is the point here? There is an exponential growth in the contention window. So, what do you mean by exponential growth here? The meaning of exponential growth is, for n is equals to 0, the contention window size is 1. For n is equals to 1, the contention window size is 2. For n is equals to 2, the contention window size is 4. For n is equals to 3, the contention window size is 8. So, this is called exponential growth in the contention window size. So, that's why we are saying that this algorithm is also called exponential back-off algorithm. Clear with me? Right. Next. So, is it allowed this exponential growth in the contention window till the contention window size becomes infinite? No. So, it means that the exponential growth in the contention window should be limited. So, means it has to be stopped at some point of time. So, till what point the exponential growth in the contention window can be continued? That is what our next point. So, the exponential growth in the contention window size is continued till n is equals to 10, till the collision number is 10. So, till n is equals to 10, the exponential growth in the contention window size is allowed. So, therefore, for n is equals to 10, what is the contention under size of K? That is, K is equals to 0 to 1023. So, 0 to 2 to the power of 10 minus 1, which is 1023. Clear? And so, till this n is equals to 10, the exponential growth in the contention under size is continued. So, once the collision number becomes n is equals to 10, that is what my next point. So, once the n value is 10, then what happens? The contention under size is so once n is equals to 10, then the contention under size is freezed. The contention under size is freezed. So, what does it mean is, till n is equals to 10, only the exponential growth in the contention under is allowed. So, once n is equals to 10, by that moment the contention under size can be freezed. Freezed means it is going to be fixed. Clear with me? So, then let's suppose if I have n is equals to 11. So, if I have collision number 11, then what is the contention under size? Then what is the contention under size? That is obviously 0 to 1023 only, because it is freezing behavior. It won't be 2047. Clear with me? It would be 1023 only, because it is freezed. So, for all the further collisions, after n is equals to 10, whatever the collisions you are having, for all of them, there is a freezing behavior in the contention window. So, this is what the scenario. So, for n is equals to 12 also, the contention window size is 0 to 1023 only. And this freezing behavior is continued till what time? That is what our next point. So, the freezing behavior, in contention window size, the freezing behavior in contention window size is continued till n is equals to 15. So, once it is n is equals to 15, so therefore, for n is equals to 15 also, the contention window size is 1023 only. So, 0 to 1023 only. Okay, so once the collision number is 16, then the frame transmission can be aborted. So, means that as per the Backoff algorithm, okay, the Backoff limit, the maximum Backoff limit is practically set to n is equals to 15. So, therefore, practically, the Backoff limit, the maximum Backoff limit, the maximum value of Backoff limit is set to 15. So, till 15 only, we are allowed the collisions in the frames, I mean between the frames. So, once the collision number becomes 16 in any two frames, then those two frames can be aborted. Clear with me? Let's suppose if I have station A here and if I have station B here, station A first have transmitted F1, station B have transmitted first F1. So, these two are collided for first time, second time, third time and so on, 10th time and so on, 15th time also. So, these number of times the collision is allowed between these frames. But for example, if there is a collision number 16 between these two frames, then station A is going to ignore frame 1 transmission and station B also going to ignore frame 1 transmission, and frame 2 can be started with respect to the A and frame 2 can be started with respect to the B also, because the previous two frames are reached already Backoff limit, which is n is equals to 15. So, beyond the Backoff limit, still there is a collision, then those two frames can be aborted. So that's why I am keeping aside, the station A is keeping aside F1 and station B also keeping aside F1. And they are started freshly with F2 transmission. So if there is a collision takes place, if there is a collision takes place between any two frames, those two frames can be retransmitted for 15 times. So if 16th time there is a collision takes place between those two collisioned frames, then those frames transmission can be aborted. This is what Backoff algorithm statement and its analysis. Clear with me? So overall, what do you mean by Backoff algorithm here? So the meaning of Backoff. So the meaning of Backoff is the process of retransmitting the collisioned frames. Clear with me? So what is Backoff definition here is, what is the definition for Backoff here is, the process of retransmitting collisioned frames. The process of retransmitting the collisioned frames. The process of retransmitting the collisioned frames is said to be Backoff method, is referred as Backoff method. So this is what exponential Backoff algorithm, and this is what exponential Backoff algorithm statement and its analysis. So I hope you are clear with this theory. In the next session, we are going to see how to do numericals on this exponential Backoff algorithm. Okay? Thank you.